right, Ben? There aren't many good ones.
Oh, I don't know.
Well, it is.
A Polish name and it's a German name.
He's from a German family.
Like Stein.
And the other thing is this McLeod is Catholic, which I didn't know until today when I read Cronin's.
All right, let's move on a little bit here, if I may. Rick Telander, it seems that you want to talk about lefties and a new study that has been done on them. What did the study say?
Well, it's troubling if you're left-handed, but since Gleason's always announcing little things, I'd like to announce something. This is my 7-year-old daughter, Carrie. Can you see that?
Hey. Yes, hi, Carrie.
She is pretty.
Look at that.
She's an athlete. She's 7 years old. She ran the mile in 8 minutes and 20 seconds. First time she's ever run a mile in her life in street clothes at her school, and was the fastest girl in her entire school. First, second, and third. Kindergarten, first, second, and third grade.
Taken after her daddy.
No,
I bet she could beat her daddy.
Taken after her daddy. 8 minutes and 20 seconds.
That's very good.
Yeah.
Thank God.
You couldn't run an eight.
Thank God she has her mother's legs.
Mother's got a bum leg now.
I can tell you about my grandson, but that's...
Anyway, I don't know where this came from, Ben, because 50 yards is too much for me. Anyway.
Go ahead.
40 was too much. The NBA, NFL.
Go ahead. Let's go.
Cruel and unfair. It is cruel and unfair. I'll still take you on in a 40, Jauss, even after all this weight you lost. Left-handers is a problem for them. As we know, not many things are designed for left-handers in this world. But here comes something that may bode even worse for left-handers. It seems, according to a recent study done by the New England Journal of Medicine, reported in the New England Journal of Medicine, that left-handers die approximately 9 years before right-handers. Right-handers die, the mean age is, or median age is 75. Left-handers is 66. Now, one of the reasons for this, left-handers, first of all, make up only 10% of the population.
You know who's left-handed at this table, don't you?
No.
I just switched the pen to this hand.
Are you left-handed?
Yes.
I never knew that, Jauss.
Well, go ahead then.
Jauss, you've got about 10 minutes left to live.
Go ahead.
Hey, now,
I'm sorry.
For all the people out there who've asked me to explain Jauss to them, I'll try to explain right now, ladies and gentlemen. He is left-handed, and he batted right-handed in baseball and softball.
All this time I've sat next to you, and you're writing with your left
hand? I just changed. 2 minutes ago,
you're
changed.
Writing with your left hand all these years?
Yeah. Go on. We have more brains than right.
I didn't.
All right, well, go ahead. I don't want to scare the man anymore.
Part of the reason they suspect. Left-handers are involved in 7.9% fatal accidents, their deaths, as opposed to only 1.5% for right-handers. And that seems to be because...
But that's not true in England when the driver sits on the other side of this car.
Well, this has to do with things like people taking scissors and stabbing themselves because they're not meant for left-handers either.
Golf courses are set up for right-handers, too.
Sure. Golf clubs.
Yeah.
Everything, certain games, I mean, like bowling is virtually impossible if you're left-handed. They oil the thing for right-handers. But none of this would matter except for the fact that in certain sports, particularly baseball, left-handers have an advantage.
No, they're discriminated against. They can only play 4 positions.
Okay, well, but at those, they only make up 10% of the population.
Well, what's the advantage?
The advantage is the ball breaks from a different direction if you're a pitcher. If you're a first baseman, you hold your glove in a different hand. And also being a batter, since most of the pitchers are right-handed,
the ball breaks into you.
The ball is going to break into you. We've had listen to this just for a start of a Hall of Fame. And I didn't even begin to really think of all the great left-handers. Ty Cobb, left-hander. Babe Ruth, left-hander. Lou Gehrig, left-hander. Wouldn't you start with those three guys?
Ted Williams,
pitcher.
Boggs.
Sandy,
those are
Sandy
you got
Koufax.
The 5 highest hitters of all time, right?
Yeah. Now, the fact that these guys are going to...
What do you mean? You're leaving out Rogers Hornsby?
He's the best right-handed hitter.
Well...
I mean, you guys could think of a lot more than I could, I'm certain.
No, we don't want to deter you, though.
Roger Maris.
He doesn't belong,
Reggie Jackson.
With those guys. Those two.
We won't argue that. But listen to some of these other people. Albert Einstein, Ben Franklin. Now, two of my favorites, Ringo Starr and Paul McCartney. One half of the Beatles were left-handed.
Beatles.
Jimi Hendrix, of course, was left-handed. Napoleon, Picasso, Michelangelo, Ronald Reagan, and George Bush, two of our, and I didn't vote for George Bush, but I am praying for him like I've never prayed for anybody. I hope he is fine.
He's okay.
For several reasons, not the least of which is, we know, his second in command. At any rate.
He's right-handed. Who's right-handed.
Yes. Yeah. He's
right-winged. Boy, we wander from one topic to another.
We've got a left-hander sitting right here, yeah. And I want to know why you weren't a Major League Baseball player.
Because I'll tell you why. When you play games as a kid and you don't have nine guys in the field, you got to hit the ball to left field. There is no right fielder. So everybody either switches over and bats right or bats left and pokes the ball to the opposite field.
Which may be why Wade Boggs is such a great hitter.
Maybe so.
If you've gone to the opposite field, look where you'd be today. But please explain to me, given the birthright of left-handedness, why in God's name did you make yourself a right-handed hitter?
I remember this. There was a time not so long ago in the middle part of this century or a little before where parents would come down on left-handed kids and say, hey, yeah, eat with this hand. Yep. It's more. My mom, who was left-handed, always used to tell me, eat right hand because otherwise you got to look
for a place
at the table.
Doesn't that make you ambidextrous, though?
Yeah, it does.
See,
I think most left-handers can do some things right-handed.
I would love to be ambidextrous. And we were talking earlier about Steve Young signing
this. I could beat you in a game of horse just by shooting lefty.
Well, without question. Now, because you can shoot either way.
Oh, yeah. I'm equally bad. I'm a 26% shooter.
Why are left-handed pitchers most sought after in baseball?
That's a good question.
Well, two reasons.
They shouldn't be for the same reason that left-handed batters are.
No, two reasons. Their curveball breaks away from right-handed batters. And
so
also,
right-handed batters.
Their slider, whatever. You don't see many of them.
That's the reason.
They negate the big power-hitting left-handers that a lot of lineups are stacked with.
Left-handed hitters can't hit lefty batters, but right-handed hitters can hit righty batters.
John McEnroe's like left-handed.
Paul Austin.
Scotty coming hard on the drive. Takes it all the way to the rack. What a power slam. Pete Grant over hard. And it came out long. Max fires it on ahead to Jordan. Michael Jordan on the drive. It'll Barkley.
Oh, boy.
The Bulls go up 10 with 6:29 left.
Gleason, people are always talking about the great deal they got at Gleason Chevrolet, Golf Mill Ford, Gleason Buick, Gleason Dodge Jeep Eagle. What's so special?
Gleason, I put a special group of guys together to give a customer a special feeling.
It's true. The Gleason team is in a league all its own.
Thank you, Gleason.
Thank you, Gleason. Thank you, Gleason. Hey, Gleason's missing.
He's out working.
Thank you, Shea and Buonauro.
Explore the prominent issues confronting sport and society on the Mid-Continent Conference's Sports Check.
We see this statement on the news about the invasion of Afghanistan and what President Carter was trying to do at that particular time. And a lot of us just never thought it was going to happen. We thought, he's threatening, there's going to be a boycott, we're not going to the Olympics. No way.
Join me, Rick Telander, each week as I interview top personalities from the world of sport on the Mid-Continent Conference's Sports Check. Only on Sports Channel.
Think of all the things that you can do in 24 hours. Channel 24 hours a day, every day.